for this incident that happened and Lekki together in 2020 and now 2021, 1 year remembrance. We went there to do the remembrance for the hero that fall on that Lekki gate. While getting there, this 2021, we started the protest with a car. The whole police, soldier, neighborhood, they deployed them to Lekki gate when we are not fighting war. And that makes me to remember what happened on 20th of October 2020. It's a very bad experience that I will never forget in my life. We started the protest at our base in Ikorodu, but we don't see much attention there. That's where we went to Lekki gate because we believe there is the powerhouse. We get there on 19th. We step on that toll gate there, that 28th. And that 28th, around 12 p.m., we left Lekki toll gate. We're coming back to our base. When we got to Obalende, there's no bus. Everywhere has been blocked by Nigeria youth. That's why we went back to Lekki toll gate. When we got to Lekki toll gate back from Obalende, we heard that Sanwo-Olu, Lagos State governor, had declared curfew. We're like, why declaring curfew where protest is going on everywhere? He gave the news again that the curfew had been shifted to 9 p.m. And we have already tried to go back to our base, but no bus to take us, so we hope that something nasty, something bad will not happen to us here. Until that 6:45 p.m., soldier came. And immediately they came, they don't just came directly to us. The first wait, gradually they got dark. Until when that 6:45 p.m., they started shooting. They started shooting, as they are shooting on the air, they are shooting straight to the protesters. Before they came there, they got there, they told us that we should sit down on the floor. Until it's when somebody beside me fell down, and I tried to help them to raise him up. When I raised him up, that is what makes me to stand up. And immediately I raised him up and I ran away. When I turned, military man flicked me very close to me, very, very close to me. The next I heard that, I know that something touched me immediately. And my body began to shake. Ah! When I looked myself, I saw blood on my shirt. I said, I have been shot. So I ran towards going to Lekki Phase 2, but I'm so weak that I won't continue. And I begin to reason that I'm going everywhere is dark. Who do I want to go and meet in this dark place? That is how I ran back to stage. Because I was in front of stage, that is why the soldier is so close to me. So I need to run back, but I don't go to that direction that they shot me, just a little bit, another direction. Before I heard that, somebody said, this guy has been shot. As I went down, I knew that they hold me. So they rushed me immediately, and they rushed me to General Hospital Marina. And I was the first person that they took that General Hospital Marina. So they started attend to me immediately. They saw that I'm severely bleeding. They started to take it up. They stitches my chest because I was shot on the chest. Here is where I was shot. So when they stitches here finished, doctor, nurse, seeing that everywhere was full of blood still. What is going on? That's how they turned me. They land my face flat. And I look at the back. They say, wow, this guy is lucky that he was shot on the chest and the blood came out from the back. And when the doctor is attending to me, somebody is calling the doctor and the doctor is giving the person the feedback. The way he said I was shot in the chest and he asked, and I heard the doctor mentioning commissioner. So it's the one that asked the doctor that, can you handle this thing here? He said, this thing was so serious, severe in the chest. So it's the commissioner that gave the doctor order to transfer me elsewhere. That's why they transferred me around 1 a.m. with their ambulance to Lasuth Hospital. The doctor said that according to the X-ray, I have fracture on my 7th rib. So thereafter, I started the treatment. After 4 days, the nurse said they want to discharge me. But I said I'm still feeling much pains. I don't want to leave the hospital. So that very day, it was already late. When we begin to hear the information, they keep on calling us that we need to leave the hospital, that soldiers, they are going from one hospital to another to make sure that they finish up the survivors from Lekki Tollgate shooting. Ha! Okay, now, it's already late. I can't leave. So the following morning, very early, we escaped from hospital. So they are searching for us everywhere. From there, we went to safe house. They bring doctor. They pay for the doctor that is taking care of me in safe house there. From that October to December, we are hiding. Till December, so it's after December that we now left safe house. We went to our different house, and that is what I'll be facing, being running around. Even till now, I'm still scared, no job, and I'm a plumber. My profession, which I do collect contracts everywhere, which I use to sponsor my entertainment industry. I use to go to location, shoot my comedy skit, or upload it. And so since then, there's no money. And the funnier part of it, till now, government, they are still lying that nobody was shot in that Lekki Tollgate, nobody died. And we went to Lagos panel, till now, no judgment. We went to Lagos panel. Where they tell our stories, we gave them evidence, everything. Till now, there is no any justice, no judgment till now. Thereafter, in that Lagos panel there, government started attacking my YouTube channel. They attacked my YouTube channel, attacked my every social media, Instagram, Facebook. I don't know why. And we came out to do the remembrance for those ones that the hero that died there. They started shooting tear gas, pepper tear gas on our eyes, started brutalizing us again. I don't know, the doctor said I need to go for another scan. And that scan is too expensive, I cannot afford that money. It's after the scan that the doctor said I can go for the next treatment, for the fraction I have. So people, please and please, to help us, we need justice in this issue. They should not allow to just suffer in vain, just suffer, just ordinary like this.